If you achieve your engineering license, will you get a pay raise? If so, how much can you expect, and how much more does a licensed professional engineer make? In this week's Pass the PE exam, I'm going to answer these questions for you. But before I do that, let me remind you that most successful engineers will tell you that getting their PE license was the biggest career growth driver that they've experienced, whether it was due to a promotion, a salary increase, or just more exciting projects to work on. You want to get your PE license. However, preparing for the PE exam can be a real challenge. But through this and other videos on this channel, you will learn everything you need to know about the licensing process, including PE exam preparation. So please be sure to subscribe to my channel here, as my weekly videos will help you pass the PE exam. And if you leave questions in the comments below, I will answer them on future videos. In fact, this video was created in response to a comment on a previous video. So, can you expect a pay raise after you have passed the PE exam and officially achieved your PE license? I know many engineers want this question answered, but are uncomfortable asking it to their supervisor or company's HR staff because they don't want people to think that they're only in it for the money. It can be uncomfortable talking about salary, and I totally understand that. But why wouldn't this be on your mind if you are an engineering professional? I mean, think about it. You studied a lot, you put in your time, and you achieved a major career milestone. Not only that, but your license immediately gives you the ability to make more of an impact within your company, because now, theoretically, you can sign and seal project plans and specifications, which may provide a huge benefit to your company. However, not only might you be asked to take on more responsibility, but if you sign and seal documents, you are taking on a lot of potential liability. Maybe more important than how much of a raise you might get is, will you be covered for liability under your company's liability insurance? And even if you are, it may behoove you to have your own policy. This is something that you should seek legal guidance on as soon as you become licensed. Many professional associations offer affordable liability insurance plans for licensed professionals. So what's the number in terms of a pay raise? In doing research on this, I have found that it varies across the board. Some companies don't provide raises for engineers who become licensed. Instead, they provide raises based on their own corporate ladder structure. For example, maybe you achieve a project manager level 2 position in your company and you get a raise. And one of the requirements for getting to that level may be to have your PE license. Now, according to a 2017 survey conducted by the American Society of Mechanical Engineers, also known as ASME, mechanical engineers with a PE license earn a median income of $133,000, almost $16,000 more than the median salary of unlicensed engineers. So they make roughly 13% more. There has also been some research around this from the National Society of Professional Engineers, or NSPE, through their Engineering Income and Salary Survey. Way back in 2010, NSPE showed that the median salary of engineers in all professions without a PE license was $94,000, whereas the median salary of engineers with a license was $99,000, a difference of about 5%. Now, while that was a while ago, I think that the combination of this data tells us that a PE license could yield a raise anywhere between 5 to 15%, depending on a number of variables, including your location, the type of engineering you do, and your job responsibilities. I highly recommend that you have an open conversation with someone in your company to find out the true answer to this question. You may also find language around this in your employee handbook. There are two last important points that I'd like to highlight on this topic. Firstly, as you may have seen in our last video where I interviewed a former professional baseball player who recently passed the PE exam in Texas, passing the exam doesn't necessarily mean you are licensed. In some states, you can take the exam prior to fulfilling the experience requirements. Number two, just because you become licensed doesn't mean that your company is going to give you increased responsibilities or expect you to sign and seal documents anytime soon, especially if you work for a larger company. You might never sign and seal plans, which also means that they may not provide additional compensation. So there you have it. There are many financial benefits associated with becoming a licensed professional engineer, but most importantly, becoming licensed raises your credibility in the field. And from a career standpoint, that can be invaluable, maybe even more important than a one-time salary increase. I hope you found this week's video helpful. In upcoming videos, I will solve some more PE exam practice problems and answer other questions from our subscribers. Pass the PE exam videos will publish weekly, so please be sure to click the subscribe button so you don't miss something that could make a substantial difference in your exam result. And please ask questions and leave comments below this video, and I will respond to you. Let me know if there's a specific topic you'd like me to cover or a question that you need answered. Pass the PE exam will have you covered. As I mentioned earlier, this video was created in response to a comment on a previous video. I'll see you next week on Pass the PE Exam.